Okay, good morning. Good morning, everyone. Naririnig ba ako? Pakitype yung yes
Apo, sir.
dun sa chat box natin. So, currently, ang present lang are the following, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, lima lang, no? Si Michael, si Natiniel, si Marley, Uriel, tsaka si Van Jeremy. No. Tapos pumapasok si Jess and Nathaniel. Bakit dalawa yung pumapasok na Nathaniel?
Sir, lilipat lang po ako sa PC.
Ah, okay. Sige, sige. Anyway. Okay.
Sige po.
So, start na tayo, no? Okay. So, paki-thumbs up nga kung nakikita natin yung screen ko. Para I could clearly, by the way, no, next week is your, I think naka-schedule kayo ng midterm examination next week, tama ba? If I am not mistaken, tama ba? Correct me if I'm wrong. Midterm examination nyo next week. Paki-type nga yung yes kung tama, kasi if mali, magkaklase tayo next week. Kasi I think sinend sa akin na parang midterm examination yung next week. Eh, no? Okay. So, start na tayo ng discussion natin. Today, no? Actually, this is the last na parang totally discussion. No? Tapos, after ng midterm yan, hands-on na tayo all throughout hanggang finals. No? Tuturuan ko na kayo ng prototyping with regards of computer human computer interaction, no? Tuturuan ko na kayo ng software na gagamitin natin for this particular subject, no? But for now, tapusin lang natin yung parang reference with the human computer interaction, kasi the HCI, the human-computer interaction, was divided into three, di ba? So you have human, you have computer, and you have interaction. And today, we'll be discussing interaction. Okay, so interaction yung topic natin today. Okay, so let's start. So start tayo with what is interaction. Okay. So what is interaction? So interactions are the way kung paano magko-communicate to the user, no? So usually interaction is a communication between the user and the system. So that is the communication. So actually the interactions has different models, ergonomics, styles and contexts. So yung mga yan madi-discuss natin later on, one by one. Okay? So, what is interaction? Again, no? So, it's a communication between the user and the system. So, is this with regards of language and action? No? So, hindi naman, no? So, actually, hindi naman. So, interaction could happen if tina-touch natin yung isang bagay, no? Kaya inahawakan natin yung isang bagay, so yung ganun, no? So, but with the human-computer interaction, no? So, it happens through navigation. So, halimbawa, kailangan nating kunin yung isang bagay using your mouse, kailangan yung i-drag. So, those are interaction already. Now, the good thing with the current situation today, before pa talaga ginagawa yung isang program or yung isang system, the user could already interact with them kahit hindi pa siya gawa. And that is called prototyping. And that prototyping has already has the concept of human-computer interaction wherein pwede mo nang gawin, no? Yung interface even without programming. At yun yung ituturo ko sa inyo later on. Okay. So, models of interaction, we have terms of interaction, we have Norman model, and then interaction framework. So these are the three models. Iisa-isahin din natin yan later on. Okay. Okay. So meron tayong tinatawag na terms of interaction. Meron tayong tinatawag na domain, goal, tasks. So yan mga yan. So when we say domain, the area of work is under study. Okay, halimbawa, graphic design, no? Yung mga ganyan. So, domain yun. Okay? So, we have goal. So, the goal is what you want to achieve. Halimbawa, no? Your domain is your graphic design, no? So, nagde-design ka ng graphics. So, yung goal mo is to create a red triangle. Yan, no? So, we also have the task. So, paano mo naman gagawin yung goal mo? Halimbawa, no? Kaya-create ka ng triangle using shape. Tapos, lalagyan mo siya ng kulay red na fill using fill tool. So, as you can see, those are the different terms na pwede nyo makita in interaction side, no? So, halimbawa, no? Usually, the interaction gives you the goal. Halimbawa, bakit ka ba mag-interact in a particular program? Simply because you have a goal. Halimbawa, kailangan mong i-message yung mother mo through messenger. So, ano yung magiging domain mo doon? Your domain is what? Your domain would be logging in to Facebook, no? Okay, tapos yung goal mo is to message your mother, and your task is what? Go to chat the messenger app, and then find or filter your mother's name, and then send the message. So that is your tasks, yeah, no? So those are some terms of interaction. So meron tayong Donald Norman's model. Ito, dadaanan lang naman natin sila, no? Hindi naman talaga natin kailangan silang sauluhin, no? So just to understand the concept with this, no, tinatouch up natin itong mga bagay na to. So we have 7 stages. We have user establishes the goal. You have formulates intention, so specific actions at interface. You have execute actions, perceive system state, interpret, and evaluate. Yan yung 7 stages. Okay. Mas para mas maintindihan natin. Look at this. Yan, no? Yan. So it's like a loop, no? Paikot-ikot lang siya. So you have, yan, no? You have the goal. You have the execution, no? Ito yung gagawin mo. Papunta dun sa system, then evaluate mo kung na-reach mo ba yung goal. Kung hindi, execution ulit, then yan. Okay? Ganun lang. So, hindi nyo na kailangan sauluhin yung mga yan, ha? Yan. So, establishing your goal. Okay. Then, this tree, no? This tree incorporates execution. And then, this another 3 steps executes evaluation. Okay? Yung mga yan. Excuse. Okay, next. Ergonomics. These are the physical aspects of interfaces, industrial interfaces. Pag sinabi natin ergonomics, no? Di ba, meron tayong ergonomic chair, mga ganun, di ba? Ano ba yung tinatawag natin ergonomics? So these are the physical interfaces. Kung ano yung nakikita natin actually in actual ano, in real world, no? Kung ano yung nakikita natin in real world. Halimbawa, ano ba yung science behind kung bakit meron kayong office chair, no? Bakit ba naitutumba yon, no? Bakit ba nai-adjust yung height? So those are ergonomics, no? So physical interfaces yon. Okay? So this is the study of the physical characteristics of interaction. Okay, so also known as human factor, but this can also be used to mean HAI. So, meaning, yung ergonomics kasi, ano yan, it also applied in it also applies in ano, in different aspects. Like for example, pwede siyang ma-apply sa airplane, ganyan, kung paano siya lumilipad, kung paano nagla-land, paano nagfo-float, no, mga ergonomics 'yon. Even yung keyboard nyo, no, the position of your keyboard, halimbawa naka-tilt ba yan, naka-flat, no, yung size niya, naka-slant, no, ergonomics din yan. Okay, so may mga ganun sila. Okay, so yan, so ergonomics good at defining standard and guidelines for constraining the way we design certain aspect of systems. Okay, so bakit yung mga office chair merong armrest, no, bakit sila na-adjust? Kasi napag-aralan na yung mga yan. Kasi napag-aralan na sila bakit sila ganun mag-behave, no? So examples ng mga ergonomics are arrangement of controls and displays, no? Sa aircon, no, familiar tayo, halimbawa, no, yung pagkaka-arrange ng mga controls and display nila, no? So usually sa aircon, laging nasa, okay, kanan, no? Kanan, laging nasa kanan madalas yung control, simply because we tend to be right-handed pagka nakaharap tayo. So yung mga ganun, no? Surrounding environment, ano naman yung surrounding environment natin? So halimbawa, no, halimbawa is seating arrangement adaptable to cope with all the sizes of the user, no, health issues also, no, physical position, yung mga ganyan, no, noise, temperature, yung mga ganyan, no, okay, kasama rin yan. Use of color like warning signals, no. Use of color such warning signals, no, kapag ka red ibig sabihin it's a warning, pagka green means go, no. Okay, so this could be a possible awareness for those color blind, no. That's why parang may pag-aaral na kapag ka stop sign usually, no, it is kulay red, no. If it is a green means a go. And kadalasan yung mga signages nyo is kulay green simply because madali silang makita. Okay? Next, let's have industrial interfaces. So, we have office interface versus industrial interface. So, sometimes, no, kung ano yung nakikita natin sa office natin, is iba yan sa makikita natin in our industrial. Okay, yung sa mismong halimbawa, sa mismong pinaka parang planta or production floor, no? Okay, so halimbawa, rate of change sa office, mabagal, no? Sa industrial, mabilis. So halimbawa, yung environment, usually in office, clean yan, no? In industrial, medyo madumi. Okay? So, yung mga ganun, no? So, sometimes, no? Sa office, syempre, naka-aircon. Minsan, in industrial, is hindi. So, those kinds of, ano. So, siguro, nakikita niyo yun. So, minsan, di ba? Halimbawa, pupunta ka sa casa, no? In an actual office, napakalinis niya. Tapos, sa labas, makikita mo, may mga oil, no? Okay, yung sa mismo kung saan nila dinadala yung sasakyan mo, you'll see there's a lot of oil and so on. So, yung mga ganun. So, those are in the difference between industrial and office setups. Now, you have glass interfaces then, no? the industrial interface as user traditional like dials and knobs, mga pihitan, no? Glass interfaces are much cheaper, not physically located, loss of context, or even complex interfaces. Usually, pagka mga glass, mga touch screens to, no? Even kahit sabihin mong plastic siya, pero plastic made, pero may mga, yung mga buttons niyan are made of glasses sometimes, no? Even yung mga ano niya, di ba? Mga cellphone niyo, those are glass interfaces kasi touch screen sila. Pero, di ba, nilalagyan niyo ng tempered glass, no? Mga ganun, those are glass interfaces. Yan, example lang to. Now, we have tinatawag na indirect manipulation. Ano naman tong indirect manipulation na to? Indirect manipulation are categorized with, again, office and industrial. So, direct manipulations are the office and indirect manipulations are the industrial. So, ano pinakaiba nila? So, in the office, user interacts with artificial world while the industrial, no, user interacts with the real world through interface. Yan, no? So, parang ganito. Yan, yung example natin dito is itong mga, ito, user to. Okay, gumagamit lang siya ng system. Pero sa mga planta, no? Si production, no? Yan, marami dyan sa SBMA, no? So, ito si production. Okay. You have the system, tapos gagawin mismo nung machine, tapos babalik sa interface, tsaka makikita yung result ni production operator. So ganyan siya, no? So makikita natin yung diferensya nila in terms of how they manipulate systems, no? And how they interact. Next is interaction styles. Ano naman yung mga different interaction styles? So usually, no, interaction styles are could be dialogue, computer, user, distinct styles or interaction. So ano yung mga yan? So ito, these are the different interaction styles. Maybe you could already relate this sa PC, no? Sa PC halimbawa, yan. We have command line interface. Ano yung mga command line interface? Ito yan, no? Halimbawa, nag-control R tayo. Tapos kinect natin CMD. Aha. Nasaan na ako? Ito. Windows R. Windows R. CMD. Yan. This is a command line interface. Yan. Example yan ng command line interface. So this is the way I am going to connect with, halimbawa, yan, gaganyan siya. Yan, this is command line interface. Yan, no? Yan. Yan, command line interface, yan. And using DOS command, okay? You have menus. Alam naman natin yung ibig sabihin ng menu. Yung mga file, no? Edit, yung mga ganyan, no? Format, yung mga yan. No? Okay? So, those are menus. Natural language, yan, through pagsasalita, no, through English or even Tagalog, no, mga ganyan. Question and answer and query dialogue, form fields and spreadsheets, yan yung mga halimbawa, nag-aano ka ng membership, no, nagka-create ka ng account. So yan, no, so yan, WIMP, no, point and click, no. And then three-dimensional interfaces like 3D, no? These are the different common interaction styles. So yan. So yan, no? So command line interface, usually yung pinakita ko kanina, direct access to the system, no? You have system functionality, tapos puro command and abbreviation, no? So usually these are used using Unix system. Unix ang ginagamit dyan. Okay, mapuputol yung Zoom session natin. And then, I'll be sending a new link dun sa ano natin. All you have to do is to join again. Okay, magsa-sign out. Okay? Yan. So next is menu. So we already knew what is also menu, no? Alam natin yung ibig sabihin ng menu. So often, no, these are clickable, no? Nakikita natin to madalas sa mga websites, no? Even in software like Microsoft Word, Excel, halimbawa gusto natin mag-open, file open, no? File save, no? File print, yung mga ganyan, those are menus. Okay, so just to be clear, no? Ano ba yung menu? So halimbawa, ito. Okay, let's continue. Paki-off yung mic. Van Jeremy, naka-open yung mic mo. Paki-off lang muna. Paki-mute yung mic mo. Okay, so yan. So let's continue our discussion. Okay. So done with menus. Okay. Next is natural language. Sige, okay lang yan. Ano yung muna? Oo. Huwag mo i-draft, ha? Huwag mo i-draft. Makakainin yung paper niyan, eh. Iyan mo lang. Tuloy-tuloy mo lang. Okay, next is natural language. So, this is familiar to users. Like, for example, text-to-speech, no? Yung mga ganun. So, yan. Halimbawa, inuutos sa aming computer. Like, give me, okay, using your chat, no? Give me text-to-speech apps. Yung nauutusan mo using, ano, using voice. Meron ba kayo naiisip? Okay? Paki-chat kung ano yung mga na-experience nyo na ginagamitan ng voice to voice commands. Okay? Bigyan nyo nga ako ng example. Paki-type dun sa chat box. Okay, so I'm waiting for the answers. Okay, any natural language applications that uses voice to command. Okay, paki-type dun sa chat box. This will serve as your participation for today, ha? Wala? Wala kayong sagot? Okay, YouTube voice search. Ano pa? So si Michael lang ba ang may sagot? Google? Okay. Yan, Siri, correct. Na? Yung mga yan, no? Okay, so yung mga sinabi niyo, correct yan. So tatlo lang, ha? Tatlo lang. Tatlo lang ang nagpa-participate. Okay, thank you, Sid. Thank you, Van. And thank you, Michael. Okay, so let's continue. So next is query interface. So ano naman to? So usually, no, these are forms, no? These are forms. Okay? So mga ganito rin sila. Yan, mga ganyan sila. So actually, hindi ko naman natin kailangan masyadong i-elaborate kasi we already experienced this. Halimbawa, nag-fill up tayo, no? So ganyan siya, form fills, no? Form fills yung mga yan, okay? Next is spreadsheets. Usually, naka Excel yan, no? Yung mga ganyan. Okay? So sophisticated variation of form filing, mga ganyan. Usually Microsoft Excel to. Next is WIMP or yung Windows icon, menus, and pointer. So, with the use of mouse din to. Yan. Kung ano nakikita nyo ngayon sa desktop, ganyan siya. Okay. So, Windows icons, menus, and pointer. So, lahat-lahat. It's a combination of all. So meron din tayong tinatawag na point and click interfaces, no? Using mouse, no? Just click something, yan. And those are icons, links, yan, mga yan. You have three-dimensional interfaces, mga buttons, no? Yung mga ganyan. So siguro na ano na natin din yan. Especially kapag ka mga nag-games kayo ng mga ano, 'di ba? Usually mga buttons nila, kala mo talaga totoong buttons. Those are three-dimensional interfaces, no? Okay. So, let's move on with the elements of your WIMP interface. Yung mga windows, no? So, yan. You have scroll bars, you have title bars, no? Itong mga to familiar naman tayo. Tama? Tama ba? Familiar tayo dito sa mga scroll bars, title bars. Yes or no? Paki-type, yes or no? Familiar tayo? Okay, that's correct. No, familiar tayo dyan. Yes, okay. So, yan. Okay, so title bars, okay. So, icons, no? So, actually, we don't need to explain some of this, no? Kasi we are already familiar with that. Icons, no? These are small pictures or image na nakalagay sa buttons, or these are clickables. Yan, pointers, the different types of pointers, yan. Ito, usually mouse, no? Okay. We also have menu, no? Yan, so pinakita ko kanina, those are menus. Okay. So meron tayong tinatawag different kinds of menus. Meron tayong pull down menu, drop down menu, fall down menu. So pagka pull down menu, i-hold down mo muna yung mouse. Pagka drop down, click lang. Pag fall down, i-hover mo lang. Okay, so naranasan naman na natin yung mga yan, okay? Usually in different sites, no? Makikita na natin yan. Now we have cascading menus and keyboard accelerators, okay? So pag sinabi nating cascading menus, ano naman itong mga cascade? Ito yung mga hierarchy menu structure. So opens new menu. Ano nangyari? Uguti mo na ano? Okay, going back. Pasensya na dyan sa storbo. Okay. Okay, so next is menu designs. Actually, alam naman na natin itong mga menus na to. Okay, let's move on with the next one. Buttons. Ayan. Ito, mga different kinds of buttons, no? Ayan. So, meron kang ayan, radio button, yung mga yan, no? We have checkboxes, no? And then, this is the common buttons that we have. Yan, yung mga submit button na ganyan. Okay. Toolbars, alam na rin natin kung ano yung itsura ni toolbars. So, basically, toolbars, di ba, in Photoshop, mga ganyan, makikita natin. These are the commonly used actions. Okay. Palettes and tear-offs. Palettes, ito yung ano, pag sa kulay, di ba? Halimbawa ito. Para lang makita natin. Ito. These are palettes. Ayan. Palettes ang tawag dyan. Okay. So, ayan. Next, we have dialog boxes. Ito naman yung mga lumalabas kapag kailangan mo yung ano, may ginawa ka. So, halimbawa, dialog boxes. Paano ko ba pa? Malalabasin si dialog boxes dito. Bawa. Ito. Info. Ayan, save, browse. To, these are the dialog boxes. Okay, yan, mga yan. So, dialog boxes yan. O kaya, no, yung nagpa-prompt mismo. Pagka, it's like message box, ganun siya. Okay, dialog boxes din yan. Next, let's move on with interactivity. Interactivity. So, ito naman yung how do you feel, no? So, speech-driven interfaces, yung mga kanina, no? Nag-ask ako sa inyo ano yung mga pwede nating voice commands, no? Yung mga ganun. So, may binigay kayo. So, those are correct. So, those are speech-driven interfaces. Okay. So, next is initiative. Okay. So, old question. Tapos, mga ano to, mga computers, no? Still in computers, like voice commands, tapos the computer will answer, no? In the WIMP interface, the user will navigate, okay? Ganyan siya. So error and repair. So you can't always avoid errors, but we can put them right. And so sometimes now in interacting with different computers, no, makikita natin at malalaman natin or ma-feel natin na merong mga errors, pero hindi nga natin sila ma-avoid. So we could not avoid computer errors, okay? Yeah, so next is context. So interaction affected by social and organizational context. So to impress, competition, mga ganyan, no? So yan. So bakit ka ba na motivate? Because of your ambition, self-satisfaction, mga ganyan. So pag sinabi kasi natin context, these are the idea. Oh, idea. So why do we interact? No? Yan, ganyan. Okay, so we interact usually. We do interact. Kagaya nyan. Na-force kayo to interact with your application such Zoom kasi may klase tayo. Okay, so ako naman, bakit ako nakikipag-interact? Kasi I need to teach you guys. So something like that. Okay, so yan. Next, experience, engagement, and fun. So ano naman itong mga to? So what is experience? We already know what is experience. Alam na natin yan kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng experience. So example, our home, entertainment, shopping. So not enough that people can use a system. Okay, so yung mga ganyan, education, yung mga ganyan, psychology of experience. Okay, so those are examples of possible experiences that we might encounter later on. So yan. So yan, example of designing experience. Dito na kasi papasok yung laboratory natin, no, later on, designing experience. Okay? Yan. So bakit ba ganyan yung itsura ng mga plastic toys, yung mga candy wrappers, no? May mga ano yan, may mga science behind that. Hindi lang yan basta dinesign, no? May mga science behind that. Okay? And yan. So, example yan, no? Okay. Yan. So, how crackers work. Example lang to. Nung parang how yung mga joke links, no, na nare-receive nyo sa email dati, no? Okay, kasi dati puso yung ganyan, no? Usually email lang talaga ang way of communicating dati. Pero nowadays ang dami na. So itong mga to, napalitan na ng mga GIF to eh. Yung mga, 'di ba? Yung mga stickers na sinasend yun sa Facebook. Yan, napalitan na sila ng ganyan. Okay? Now we have physical design, no? So these are the constraints. So ergonomic, physical, safety, aesthetic, and economic. So in our user designs and experience, pasok yung aesthetic. Pag sinabi natin aesthetic, dapat maganda tignan. No? Okay. Design trade-offs. Ito naman. Ito importante to. Design trade-offs. Okay. So bigyan ko kayo ng example. Kung halimbawa, bibigyan ko kayo ng cellphone, no? Yan, cellphone na ganito versus dun sa smartphone nyo. Anong mas pipiliin nyo kung ang kailangan nyo lang araw-araw is mag-text? Okay, pakitype yung answer nyo. Kung bibigyan ko kayo ng cellphone, tapos lagi kayo nagda-drive, no? Okay, lagi kayo nagda-drive, no? Ang trabaho mo sa akin mag-drive, no? Tatawagan lang kita lagi, no? Okay. So, anong pipili mo? Smartphone or this kind of cellphone? Ano ba to? Ano bang ano to? This is analog pa eh. Okay? So, si Michael lang yata yung nakikinig sa akin. How about the others? Anong pipiliin nyo? Smartphone, no? Okay. So, dito kasi papasok yung tinatawag nating trade-off, no? Yung ano. So, kung halimbawa, no? Usually, you would say smartphone, no? Smartphone. Yung trade-off kasi na tinatawag natin is, it's like, laging ano, laging merong na ano na sa sacrifice na feature. Halimbawa ito. Itong example natin ito, no? Versus dun sa smartphone. Lagi ka nagda-drive, no? Lagi ka nagda-drive. Always 'yon. So isa sa mga problema sa mga smartphone is what? Pag nagda-drive ka. So let's say for example, 8 hours nasa daan ka. Hindi ka pwedeng mag-text ng isang kamay gamit ang smartphone. Okay? Kaya ang trabaho mo sa akin, driver ka. Okay? Usually, pag driver, sa ulado mo naman na lahat ng daan eh. Kung same lang yung route mo. So you don't need the map. And usually, cars do have already a navigation or map. So mas okay sa'yo ito. Okay? Mas okay sa'yo yan. Okay? Hindi mo na kailangan ng ibang features. Hindi mo kailangan ng Facebook. Hindi mo kailangan. Ito. Kasi ito, kahit isang kamay, makakapag ano ka. Kahit hindi mo nga tinitignan, makakapag-message ka dito eh. Okay? Unlike sa smartphone, hindi. Okay? So those are yung tinatawag natin trade-offs na tinatawag. Okay? So the greater the choices you have, the harder for you to get it. I mean, the harder for you to decide what to do. Pero bigyan mo halimbawa ng isang yung gagawin niya lang talaga. Tapos yun lang yung functionality niya. Okay? So, what will happen? Mas mabilis niyang nagagawa yung dapat niyang gawin. Another example, yung mga lola niyo halimbawa, no? Bigyan mo sila ng remote. Yung lumang remote, yung LED TV, tapos yung remote ng smart TV. So, usually, halimbawa, papalipat mo yung channel, no? Papalipat mo sa ganito. Mas nahihirapan sila mag-decide kapag ka-smart TV yung gamit nilang remote kasi ang daming selection. Ang daming buttons. Okay, those are trade-offs na tinatawag natin, okay? Yan. Okay. Ito, yan, mga yan, no? So, ito mga to, mga yes, no buttons lang to, eh, no? Okay, so unlike yung mga ito, these are also another series of controllers, mga rotators, no? Tino-twist lang, no? Pinipindot lang, yung mga yan. Hindi sila mahirap gamitin. Unlike pagka-smart na, no? Especially if they are not, ano, medyo hindi nila ganun ka saulado kung paano gagamitin. Now we have also physical layout, so these are logical relationship spatial grouping. So yan mga yan, so mga touch screens usually makikita natin sa mga ovens natin, no? Yan, meron din tayong dials, no? To. Yan, sa mga knobs, no? Ito yung mga switches. Yan, mga switches to. Yan. Okay. And then, you have value organizational design. So, when we say coercion, this is you tell people what to do, no? Enculturation explains or establish support. So, share points. Okay. So next is emergence, so design process. So this is the value and organizational design. So this is the, when we say value and organizational design, ito yung mga sinusunod natin in actual work. Maybe currently, medyo we are trying to grasp what is the value and organizational. Pero kapag once na nakainatay sa isang organization, makikita natin yung value ng isang organization, and these are the different interactions that you might encounter later on. So, if you want someone to do something, make it easy for them, and then understand their values. I want you to inculcate this, no? Ito dapat yung tandaan natin, kasi yung susunod ng mga discussions natin, laging ganito. Okay, so, kailangan mas madali sa tao, no? Mas madali dun sa person na gawin yung mga bagay-bagay. Okay, hindi mo sila bigyan, hindi mo sila kailangan bigyan ng mga choices na hindi nila kailangan. So halimbawa, okay, kailangan lang nila manood ng movie. So bigyan mo sila ng application na manonood lang sila ng movie. Okay? Hindi mo na sila kailangan bigyan na makakapag-chat pa sila sa mga friends nila, no? So kung ano lang yung kailangan, okay? Yun lang yung ibigay nyo. Okay, so that's the general lesson of the interaction. Okay, so coming up, no? Coming up, siguro, I'm going to provide a short quiz, no? Will be uploaded that tomorrow, no? So all you have to do is to just, you know, take the quiz, short quiz lang yon, and then I will be uploading your examination most probably Tuesday next week. You can take that until Thursday, until that week, kasi examination week naman. And then we will meet again after next week. Okay, so start na tayo ng laboratory activities natin nun. Okay, so clear ba yun? Pakitype nga clear yung sa instruction ko. Okay. Oh yeah, and so this ano naman, this lessons is recorded, so I will be uploading it pa rin naman dun sa Canvas. So all you have to do is to, by the way, this one is already uploaded, the PowerPoint presentation, so you may reference this in your actual quiz, no? So yon, questions meron ba? Do we have any questions? Paki-type nan if wala, paki-type nan para alam ko na clear. Okay, none, okay. So, yon. Yes. Okay. So, anyway, now if you have questions with regards of our LMS, our Canvas, now you may question us, you may reach me at our chat box. Kung meron lang naman. If none naman, okay lang, tuloy-tuloy na. So, that would be it for today, no? Thank you for attending our class, and I'll see you guys next week after the midterm examination. Bye-bye. Keep safe.
Thank you po, sir.
Okay.
Thank you po, sir.
Okay.